गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द अनदर टॉपिक दैट इज एक्सरे डिफ्रेक्शन. एक्सरेज वर डिस्कवर्ड बाय विलहेम रोइंगटन हु कॉल्ड देम एक्सरेज बिकॉज द नेचर एट फर्स्ट वाज नोन. सो एक्सरेज आर आल्सो कॉल्ड रोइंगटन रेज. एक्सरेज डिफ्रेक्शन इन क्रिस्टल वाज डिस्कवर्ड बाय मैक्स वॉन लुई. द वेवलेंथ रेंज इज 10^-7 टू अबाउट 10^-15 मीटर. The penetrating power of X-rays depending upon energy also. There are two types of X-rays, hard X-ray and the soft X-rays. Hard X-ray which have high frequency and have more energy, whereas soft X-rays which have less penetrating and low energy levels. X-rays are short wavelength electromagnetic radiations produced by the deceleration of high energy electrons or by electronic transition of electrons in the inner orbital of atoms. X-ray region is 0.1 angstrom and analytical purpose it is 0.722 angstroms. Principle, the extra diffraction is based on constructive interference of monochromatic X-rays and a crystalline sample. These X-rays are generated by a cathode ray tube filtered to produce monochromatic radiation, collimated to concentrate and directed towards the sample. The interaction of the incident rays with the sample produces constructive interference when condition satisfy Bragg's law. Now here we will discuss what is Bragg's law. The path difference between ray 1 and ray 2 is called 2d sine theta. So here from the diagram you can see there is a plane which is where the atoms are placed at the equal distance and the angle between them is theta, that is d sine theta. And when we calculate the path difference we will consider it as 2d sine theta. And constructive interference of the reflected beams emerging from two different planes will take place if the path's length of two rays is equal to whole number of wavelength. For constructive interference, n lambda is equal to 2d sine theta. This is called Bragg's law. Instrumentation. In instrumentation, it contains X-rays, collimator, monochromator, and detectors. So how the X-rays can be produced? X-rays are generated when high velocity electrons impinge on the metal target. Approximately 1% of the total energy of the electron beam is converted into X radiation, the remainder being dissipated as heat. Many types of X-ray tubes are available which are used for producing X-rays. Here A highlights in the diagram, A highlights positive voltage in the form of anode having the target A. B is the battery to emit thermionic electrons. C is the cathode filament of tungsten metal. The electrons are accelerated towards the target A. On striking the target, the electron transfer their energy to its metallic surface which gives off X-ray radiation. And the collimator. In order to get a narrow beam of X-rays, the X-rays generated by the target material are allowed to pass through a collimator which consists of two sets of closely packed metal plates separated by a small gap. The collimator absorbs all the X-rays except the narrow beam that passes between the gap. The types of monochromators. In order to do monochromatization, two methods are available, that is filter method and the crystal monochromators. Now let us discuss about the filter. X-ray beam may be partly monochromatized by insertion of a suitable filter. A filter is a window of material that absorbs undesirable radiation but allow the radiation of required wavelength to pass. Crystal monochromators. Crystal monochromator is made up of suitable crystalline material positioned in the X-ray beam so that the angle of reflecting planes satisfied the Bragg's equation for the required wavelength. The beam is split up into component wavelengths. Crystals used in monochromator are made up of materials like NaCl, lithium, fluoride, quartz, etc. Now let us discuss about the detectors. The X-ray intensities can be measured and recorded either by photographic methods, counter methods, means, and the counter method include Geiger-Müller tube counter, proportional counter, scintillation detector, solid state semiconductor detector, and semiconductor detector. Both these types of method depend on ability of X-rays to ionize matter and differ only in subsequent fate of electrons produced by the ionizing process. Now we will elaborate, or we will discuss about the photographic method. To record the position and intensity of X-ray beam, a plane or cylindrical film is used. The film after exposing to X-ray is developed. The blackening of the developed film is expressed in terms of density units. D is given by D is equal to log I naught upon I. I zero or I naught is incident intensities. I is transmitted intensity. D is total energy that causes blackening of the film. D is measured by densitometer. The photographic method is mainly used in diffraction studies since it reveals the entire diffraction pattern on a single film. And the disadvantage is time consuming and uses exposure of several hours. And the counter method, number first is Geiger-Müller tube counter. Geiger tube is filled with inert gas like argon. Central wire anode is maintained at a positive potential of 800 to 250 volt. The electron is accelerated by the potential gradient and causes the ionization of the large number of argon atoms, resulting in production of a valence of electrons that are traveling towards the central anode. And respective detectors. Now the diffraction methods, the X-ray diffraction methods, they are Louis photographic method, Bragg's X-ray spectrometer method, rotating crystal method, and the powder method. Here is the types of different X-ray diffraction methods. Louis, rotating crystal, and powder. Transmission Louis method. In the transmission Louis method, the film is placed behind the crystal to record beams which are transmitted through the crystal. One side of the cone of Louis reflection is defined by the transmitted beam. The film intersects the cone with the diffraction spots generally lying on an eclipse. Can be used to orient crystals for solid state experiments. Most suitable for investigation of preferred orientation sheet, particularly confined to lower diffraction angles. Also used in determination of symmetry of single crystals. Here are the another methods for X-ray diffraction. Now the application of X-ray diffraction. Number first is structure of crystal, that we can study the structure of different crystals, polymer characterization, state of annealing metals, particle size determination, spot counting method, broadening of diffraction lines, low angle scattering, application of diffraction method to complexes, determination of cis-trans isomerization, determination of linkage isomerism, miscellaneous applications. That's it.